Oh, the music box is right around the corner there. You see that there?
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, this is, okay, that very first day that we were doing online, and I kept running out of the room, I really couldn't believe that you just turned the online thing on. I couldn't believe it. It was like, I panicked, really. And then I ran out of the room, and then when I came back, I assumed that you would have turned it off because I was so embarrassed. And of course you didn't, which made me run out of the room again. I was like, I'm real. This is really happening. I was like in a time warp, and yeah, that was.
And now it's like easy for you, right?
Well, I just pressed the button. I was like, well, I don't know what I'm going to talk about. But like you said, that's kind of sometimes the most entertaining thing to watch. Like, you know.
Because it's unscripted, you know? I mean,
yeah.
Scripted reality is interesting. I mean, there's so many scripted reality shows, but this is just kind of unscripted, you
it's
know?
It's unscripted.
Yeah.
And,
now, there is a time for scripted lessons, right?
Right.
But, you know, but just kind of going live and just, you know, seeing kind of a different side of things.
Like
but,
how people interact and how things just.
But what art lesson are you up to now? So, you know, because you number all your lessons.
I
so.
Sure do. But, you know, some lessons I had pre-recorded, but I didn't edit them yet.
Yeah,
so
that's okay.
Not up,
well, I'm just trying to see how many times you, like, made videos.
Oh, yeah.
Is kind of fun. You're like a seasoned pro now.
I think I'm 46,
46,
maybe?
Yeah. So you've gone live, like, well over 40 times.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And so I'm getting the hang of it. And my biggest struggle is to try and keep the videos very concise, so that people aren't waiting around for me to pick up the next piece of paper,
mm-hmm.
so that I really structure the whole video before I even click
right.
the button.
Mm-hmm. No, that's also very important. I guess that was kind of my point is there's not a script to it, but you have kind of like a lesson plan. You know?
Yeah.
So you're not just shooting off the cuff like, oh,
right.
let's talk about this mm-hmm. today.
Yeah, and my goal is to try and keep the demonstration, lecture, whatever you call it, very short. So,
mm-hmm.
I like, try and get it all done in 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And one of my friends, she said she learned something within 2 minutes of my video. So
awesome.
I like, yeah. I was like, thank you very much for helping out there.
Yeah.
So,
Go to your videos there?
My videos.
Yeah. Let's see here.
Yeah, look at all
those. Part one, live stream. All right. That's 43. That's probably 44, 45, and 40. Yeah, so you've done like 46 lessons there. 46 lives.
I've got plenty more to do.
That's pretty good. Yeah, I mean, that's great. I mean, half the battle is just getting started. But then, like, I mean, I've said this many times. If you just keep doing it over and over, it becomes less anxious.
Yeah, we still got the COVID screen, so we should be okay.
Or hyperbolic chamber, as they call it. I don't know if that even makes sense or not. It sounds like the appropriate thing to call us if we were separated.
Right.
What's that movie, like, so close? But remember the movie where the two people couldn't touch?
Look, I know her. Hi.
Ain't going there, Mary.
Hi. So, anyway, I'm getting really close to doing the video. And maybe, Mary, you could help me out one day testing it out. Yeah, I think it's going to be early October when I start going.
Mm-hmm.
Live lessons. So
there's
anyway,
like a little heart that just popped up there. What was that? Are you on YouTube now instead of Facebook?
I don't know. No, I'm on Facebook.
Yeah? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, there's the heart.
Yeah, what was that there? Mm-hmm. Oh, you can't. It doesn't show you.
It doesn't show you. But anyway, thanks for the love.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Maybe you can go here and see. Oh, it was Mary. It was also Mary. Thank you, Mary.
Oh, thank you, Mary. Hope you're doing well. I mean, the goal is really to try and connect because I know that we all don't get out of the house, and it really is hard. So it would be nice to interact, and that's why I'm going to be going live with these lessons, because then we at least get to chat. Like, we have an interactive chat, you know? So I hope you join me with that. I'm going to make them super affordable. Donation level minimum at, what, $10 or something?
I don't think it was actually adding to broadcast before. That was just a notification.
Oh.
Yeah, so yeah, what you want to do is when you see that thing comes up, you put the little comment button thing. You put this little comment window up here, and see where it says add to broadcast. So yes, you do it so you can see it. So we already did the first one, so do the bottom one now.
Yay!
Yeah, you could just drag it in, or you can click add to broadcast.
Okay.
Either one. Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
There you go. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, so yeah, you can click it again. So watch, click it again there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, beach ball.
Add too much to work.
Oh.
Gosh, that little computer.
Hold on, we should do like a little. We should act like we're playing the beach ball here. While it's doing it. Set.
Oh.
Anyways,
gosh.
But yeah, that's you just drag it then.
So what I've done is I've taken the gallery in the front room of the Isaac Taylor House, where y'all know I've been there for about 7 years, and I'm moving back, and I'm now in the bridal suite of the Isaac Taylor House, and this is where the classroom is going to be, and I'm going to basically just do the online classroom for right now, because this COVID thing is still going on out there pretty strong. I know people who've had it, and I know people who are still having it, so... when I was doing the move, I had tons of art books, and I was moving the art books. So show what I found here.
This is the Art of Eric Carle.
Yeah,
so
we were talking about this last time live with you.
Yeah, I had made this little shark on my iPad that Procreate, and it just kind of turned into kind of an Eric Carle style shark.
Yeah,
and
we all know this book. Maybe see this one on the back page. Look at that one.
Yeah.
Remember that book? Yeah. It was a great book. It was like some hungry caterpillar.
The Hungry Caterpillar. That's one my son reads. That I read. It's The Hungry Caterpillar. Yeah. The Very Hungry Caterpillar. Yeah, we love that book. Yeah. Yeah, this is what he does, though. He takes these colored tissue paper. So it's tissue paper, and then he paints them, and he makes all patterns on them, and then he'll cut little strips of them, and then he puts that into a shape of something, you know?
That's pretty cool.
We first saw him on Mr. Rogers, actually. Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
Yeah, I went to school in Pittsburgh, and my dorm was right next to Mr. Rogers' studio.
Oh, really? Yeah.
But I was a little too nervous. I was a little too scared at that time to actually have the guts to walk up to say hi to Mr. Rogers. I was right there. I could have done it, but I just didn't have the courage.
We need a Mr. Rogers again.
Yeah, we need
another one.
Here
it is. Yeah, the Very Hungry Caterpillar. Yeah,
there
see?
He is.
Yeah, so these are the kind of different strips of the colored tissue paper that he kind of puts in little strips and then kind of arranges it and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's very whimsical and just kind of...
I think doing
cool.
art, it just keeps your mind focused on positive things.
Mm.
That way, all those stresses, you know, they kind of just disappear off to the wayside. And you're just focused on, you know, the next line or the next piece of paper you have to cut or
mm-hmm.
the next piece of, or next color that you put down.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway.
Yeah, and art doesn't have to be, everything. When people think of artists, I think everyone thinks of a painter.
Wait
a minute. Or someone
that
draws and sketches.
Wait a minute. I just see your t-shirt. Wow.
Yeah. Uh-huh. The university, it's all about you. University.
University.
See?
This is you. This is Bear City University. This is yours.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is me.
You are it. Bear City
That's
University.
It. Yeah, whenever I do like live in person trainings, which
right.
aren't doing it right now. But yeah, I was this is like my professor shirt.
That
know?
Is awesome.
It's like when Kanye West was like cool, like in college dropout CD years before he got weird. Like this is kind of like my college persona.
I like that. I like that t-shirt.
Do you listen to Kanye West? Probably don't listen to Kanye West.
No. I saw that. I saw him on that award show. I don't know if you remember that. Well, anyway.
I'm not sure
what
to watch it yet.
And then the other book I found was one he already has at home. Brad already uses this. This is for calligraphy.
Yeah, this is actually the exact
that
book that I have
yeah.
that I kind of learned the different writing
yeah,
styles.
To
yeah.
learn. Anyway.
Oh, that's what I was going to say with art, though. Yeah, I just think most people associate artists with, I'm an artist, I'm a painter, or acrylic or oil painter, or I sketch things, you know? But,
yeah.
I mean, like, as an example, like the other day, my son had this thing, he wanted me to make a boat, and... literally, he handed me a piece of paper that he just scribbled on, and he was like, "Make this into a boat." And I'm like, "Okay." So you know,
that is magic.
Yeah. So I just went and I found like an origami lesson to turn it into a paper boat.
Okay.
You know?
Cool.
So then we made a paper boat, and then I just had him just draw the outside with like a little couple little eyes, a little smile, and we kind of turned like this little shark boat. You know, but for him, that's kind of art. You know, that's just. It's making something with your hand,
right,
which is what I did, and then he kind of drew the rest of the boat stuff on the outside, and that's creative for him, and now he gets to live in this kind of whole new world of imagination and using his mind to think about stuff. And so I guess to my point is that's art in a very simple form, but that's all it really needs to be.
Right. He's only 4, right?
Yeah, he's 4, yeah.
Yeah, so for him, the refrigerator is the Metropolitan Museum of Art.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah. He loves, to draw, yeah.
If
actually,
you get your art hung on that refrigerator, that's big time.
My wife is actually really the one to credit with that because she does projects with him constantly. I mean, actually, they just got like a little paper making kit. So they did like that.
Mush up the paper.
Yeah, the pulp and stuff.
Yeah.
And then they pressed it down and she put it in the oven to dry. But it's like they have colored paper. And then what they did is they took one of the sheets and he used that as the basis to make a greeting card for our for her sister's anniversary yesterday.
Oh, that's just so sweet.
Yeah, so he really likes that kind of stuff. But he's also into like monster trucks and destroying things at the same time. You know what I mean? So it's not like he's all about art or something, but it's just kind of a different way to express, you
right.
know?
And I think we all have to be able to express ourselves.
Yeah.
Know, without adding any harm to the universe.
Yeah. I think a lot of people say, like, I'm not creative, but I think most people are creative. They just, when people think of creators, they think of art. They think
right.
of people
makers.
That can draw, you know, a Mona Lisa or something,
yeah.
you know, or paint the Mona Lisa.
Yeah.
But, I mean, most people create every day of their life.
They yeah, they do. Yeah, you're a highly creative marketing.
Well, and that's it. Yeah, I mean, I'm creative in my own way. You know, I mean, I definitely can't. I won't say that I couldn't paint that. I just have no desire to paint that.
Yeah,
so that's why I can't do it because
right.
I have no. I see no appreciation in that.
See, there's priorities, right?
Yeah.
Like your priorities are different.
Yeah,
and that's great. We all need to have. An appreciation for everything.
But, like, this is kind of art, I guess, if you think
that's
about
totally
it.
Totally.
You know
art.
What I mean? If you,
it's
wearable art. I like wearable art.
Yeah.
You know?
And you designed it, right?
Yeah. Well, I designed the logo. But then it's actually hard to see on the camera, but you can see here there's like a little graduation cap.
Oh,
let me see
yeah,
if I
can
kind of.
Oh,
you can see
yeah,
a little
there
better there now.
It is.
There's like a little graduation cap that I put on. I'm like a little
thing.
There. Yeah. So I just kind of add a little thing.
Are you selling these?
They are available for sale on shopthebear.com.
Shopthebear.com.
I get one order like every 3 months with it.
Yeah, but you might get more orders.
I actually don't have this one available. I'm not sure why this would appeal.
Because
to
you
people,
actually have to join your university.
It's like a free thing. It's the I have the I'm with the bear shirt.
Right.
So, like I have that one there where he's like holding a phone and a coffee cup.
Right.
So I have that. And, actually, here's the, it's kind of funny, actually, this is one of the very last classes I did with the Small Business Center. I'll find it here. I was wearing the shirt, but then I had a coffee cup in my hand with my phone, and so I thought it made for kind of a funny,
So the Small Business Center, are they giving classes in-house now, or are they still? Is it still COVID time?
They're doing it via Zoom. Well, it's like a WebEx thing.
Okay.
But it's like a Zoom kind of thing. Yeah.
Okay.
We'll be able to see that, but there
yeah.
we go. So I had the shirt on, and then you can kind of see the phone and the coffee cup, which is the same thing of you know the coffee cup and then the phone.
That's
So that one I do sell, but there's a few people that have that shirt there.
That's great.
And then I have my Clock Tower Lightning shirt. That one is available as well, and it just says New Bern, but it's in the font from Back to the Future.
Oh, okay.
It's in that font. So yeah.
Wow, I'm really glad you came in today.
Yeah.
I appreciate your help and getting this all kind of worked out. All the great things.
This is great. Thank you very much for the book. This is very.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to make sure that my son knows that this came from.
From a friend.
From Mrs. Lisa Bisbee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Well, have a great day, y'all. We'll see you next time.